Hello everyone, here welcome back to your class 1 science class and your chapter Air Around Us, which we already completed the text part, right? And this exercise part we have to complete it. So today we will start this exercise part of the Air Around Us, that is your page number 47. Page number 47. So everyone, open your book, take your copy book with you, page number 47. So the first one, option question A, that tick the correct answer. You know, here are some questions and according the questions you will get three options. You have to choose the correct one, you have to tick it, right? So let's see, let's start the question number 1. That is, we fill dash in a cycle tube. As I am writing here in full sentence, so you have to write here also in full sentence, okay? We fill dash in a cycle tube, in a cycle tube. So here three options are: option A, water; option B, air; option C, food. So which thing we fill in a cycle tube? You know this? Yes, that is air. That is air. So option B, air, is the correct answer. Option B, air, is the correct answer. Okay. So we fill air in a cycle tube. We fill air in a cycle tube. Next is the question 2. That is, we need air too. We need air too. We need air too. Here also three options: option A, breathe; option B, wear; option C, wash. So why we need air? You know, we need air to breathe, to take breath. So option A is the correct answer. So that is breath, B-R-A-T-H-E, breath, B-R-E-A-T-H-E, breath. So we need air to breathe, okay? Next is the question number 3, and that is, a dash needs air to fly. A dash needs air to fly. So who needs air to fly? For option A, windmill; option B, swimming tube; option C, helicopter. Who need air to fly? Windmill, yes, windmill also need air, but that's not flying, right? That's they need air to move the fan. Only the helicopter needs air to fly. So here option C, helicopter, helicopter. Helicopter needs air to fly. Helicopter needs air to fly. So here we fill air in a cycle tube. Question 2, we need air to breathe. And 3, a helicopter needs air to fly. Okay, so we completed the question A. You can see the board. So I am now erasing the question A. Now go to the question B. Circle the odd ones. Circle the odd ones. So here one is balloon, football, kite. So among these three words, you have to choose the odd one. And you have to know the reason also, that why you choose the odd one, right? So first one is balloon, football and kite. I'm writing here balloon, football and kite. So tell me balloon, football or kite. Here you can choose which you want to choose. Okay, that balloon and kite, balloon and kite and the football. So here we can feel the air in football, we can feel the air in balloon also, but we cannot feel the air in kite. So I am choosing the odd one, that is kite, because we can I can feel the air in the football, in the balloon, but not in the kite. Okay, next is wind, air and tree. Wind, air, tree. See which is the odd one, you can choose it easily, because you know the air is around us and moving air is called wind. So two things are similar, but tree is not the similar with others two, right? So tree is the another thing, not the similar to wind and air. So that's why we choose their tree. And the next is glider, sailboat and car. And these things also so easy, you know, glider, sailboat and car. You know, glider and sailboat can move the help of air. Glider and sailboat can move the help of air, but car is not moving the help of air. So car is the odd one. Car is the odd one. Okay. So we choose the three odd words on question number B. Hope you all can see the board now. Okay, so today we discussed on question A and question B, and the rest of the part we will discuss on your next class. So have a nice day everyone, and bye.